بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear brothers, we'll continue inshallah explaining the Aqeedah Al-Wassitiyyah of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. We almost finished with the introduction in which he mentioned or listed the pillars of Iman, and then he started putting the fundamentals or the, I would say, the basis for Asma and Sifat, the names of Allah and His attributes. So he is like listing list of them one after the other. And after he finishes these rules, I would say, he listed probably 100 verses from the Quran to support why he came up with this. You see, that's why it's very strong, because he said in the beginning he was challenging others. If you can bring anything from my Aqeedah or the Aqeedah of Ahl Sunnah and Jama'ah, anything not from the Book of Allah or the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or any support for it. So when he listed his rules, he supported it with probably 100 verses or more, and probably 20-25 hadith from the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's why he says this is the Aqeedah of Ahl Sunnah, and that's why I came up with. So he did not come or fabricated anything. He was able to get this collection together and give it to the people. This is our belief as Ahl Sunnah and Jama'ah. So he reached when he was saying, وَمِنَ الْإِيمَانِ بِاللَّهِ الْإِيمَانِ بِمَا وَصَفَ بِهِ نَفْسَهِ فِي كِتَابِهِ وَبِمَا وَصَفَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَمَا وَصَفَهُ بِهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنْ غَيْرِ تَحْرِيفٍ وَلَا تَعْطِيلٍ وَمِنْ غَيْرِ تَكْيِيفٍ وَلَا تَمْثِيلٍ. I will stop here and try to explain what I said in Arabic. He said, rahimahullah, that it's part of our aqeedah, part of our iman, our faith, our belief, that we believe what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described Himself in His names or attributes that listed or mentioned in the Quran, okay? And whatever the Prophet ﷺ described Him with, okay? Then he said, مِنْ غَيْرِ تَحْرِيف, no inclination, no changing, no alteration. The way it came, he listed it. This is the belief of Ahl Sunnah and Jama'ah. He did not change the meaning. He just take it as is. And wala ta'til means when Allah give you the say the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alim, He is alim. The attribute of alim, some of the groups who are deviated, they say He's alim but without ilm. It doesn't fit. How you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alim, but they also take away the ilm away from Him. You call Him sami' but without sam', without hearing. So that's what we, what the Shaykh mentioned. The Shaykh said, بِمَا وَصَفَ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ, mean whatever he described himself in the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, for us, if you read the Quran, and as Muslims, we believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described Himself Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, His names, He's the Alim, He's the Sami'. So all these attributes and all these names that came in the Quran, we believe in them, because you cannot deny anything from the Quran, and you have to take the meaning as is. You cannot change it. We affirm what Allah affirms for Himself, and we deny what He denies for Himself. It's not for us to make different interpretations. Okay? When he said, ولا تحريف, تحريف was an inclination or deformation of the meaning. That's what it means. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala said, why I used the word tahrif, I did not use the word ta'wil. or other words. The word ta'wil in Arabic, which is in a way means interpretation, can be used in a different means. And it's used by the scholars of fiqh and the scholars of tafsir, they use the word ta'wil. And it came actually in the Quran. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ تَأْوِيلَهُ إِلَّا اللَّهِ The meaning or the purpose or the meaning of these verses, Allah only knows. That's what the verse in the chapter of Al-Imran says. وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ And the continuation of the verse. But the ulama says that ta'wil could be used in different way. When you ask somebody who changes the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says this is ta'wil. No, it's not ta'wil, it's tahrif. So this is tahrif, it's not ta'wil. Ta'wil is a correct interpretation. They can be the same meaning if they have support. They have a proof from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they have a proof from the book or the sunnah, then we can say this is a correct interpretation or correct ta'wil. So, when you say tahrif, that means when somebody gives you attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or a name, we do not change the meaning. When Allah says in the Quran, بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانِ يُنْفِقُ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ Allah's hands are open and He will give anyone. Now, if somebody comes to you, he says the yadan of Allah means His power. What do you say to him? Can we say this? No, of course, we cannot. We, Ahlul Sunnah, we describe him, he said he has yadain. We say he has yadain. This is the way we should say, or actually must say. There's no other way. The other interpretations are wrong. You are calling Allah, if somebody changes these things, he's calling Allah by things that he should not do that. That's very important to understand. That's why Tawheed Asma and Sifat, the names of Allah and attributes, is very risky. You cannot call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by names or attributes that he did not call himself with. When he said, بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانْ We say Allah affirmed in his book that he has yadin, hands. But we cannot change the meaning to power. See, this is what we call tahrif now. We change the meaning. Okay, that's what we are trying to say here. وَلَا تَعْطِيل Negation. You know, Allah has an attribute. Attribute is the hand, the face, the ilm, the sama', the hearing. You cannot say Allah is sami', but without sama'. How come? يعني you're saying He's sami', we accept the name, but we do not accept the attribute. This is what the Mu'tazila said. We are okay with the names, but we are not okay with the attributes. Because if we say Allah is sami', like His creation, we are making Him similar to His creation, which is not right. This is not right because Allah said about Himself, He is Sami'. So we, as Ahl Sunnah, we say He is Sami'. We affirm the name and we affirm the attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They take the attribute off, away. And that's not right. What you are doing here is you are calling Allah with the fiction. That's what they are doing. That's why Asma and Sifat, Tawheed Asma and Sifat is very important because you are the one who are changing the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are committing. When we say subhanAllah, what does it mean? When we say subhanAllah, it means we call Allah that He has no defections. He's perfect. We are saying because He's perfect, He's complete. That's what it means. When we have defects to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's names and His attributes, we're calling Allah by defections, which is not acceptable, and become sincere or serious violation. It's not easy. People might take it trivial. No, it's not. Okay? So, ta'til means you have an attribute You take away its meaning. You negate the meaning completely. You stop it as if it doesn't exist, which is not right. When you say Allah says in the Quran, وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ, Allah has a face. Then you say Allah has no face. Or بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُطَتَانِ. No, it's not yadan, yadan, hands, not hands. It's something else. You are negating and you're making inclination as well. So that's why Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah used these two words, tahreef and ta'teel. And that's why other groups fall into this. Maturidiyah, Asha'ira, they said, we accept asma, but sifat, not all. In the Quran, you read Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ويحبهم الله ويحبونه يحبون الله we love Allah سبحانه وتعالى قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. It's very obvious that Allah would love the good slaves of Him. The ones who worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى, Allah will love them. You say Allah doesn't love, يعني you either the Quran is right or His interpretation is right. No, the Quran is the one right. And their interpretation is wrong because they are changing the meaning of the word. That's what it is. That's why without ta'til means we don't negate the meaning of the attribute. We do not change it or alter the meaning of it. And he said, وَمِنْ غَيْرِ تَكْيِيفٍ وَلَا تَمْثِيلٍ. Now, the word takyif, you know what takyif means? Like how you say how, يعني you say بل يداه مبسوطتان, how يعني it's our like my hand. How does it look? Does anybody know? We don't know. We have not seen Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We cannot say it's like my hand or your hand or it has five fingers or six. We cannot. Anybody who claims he's seen this is making a big mistake. Or he claims that it looks like this or like that, is claiming, making wrong assumption, actually making a great sin. You cannot call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by these things you don't know. قل إنما حرم ربي الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن والإثم والبغي بغير الحق وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا وَأَن تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah made it forbidden, haram, to say the bad things, or taking the rights of others, or making shirk, or saying about Allah anything you don't know. It's haram. It's haram to anybody calling Allah some names. That's why the greatest shirk is you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the Father, for instance. Allah is not the Father. Allah is Allah. He has a son. This is actually an insult. وَعْلِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ. When somebody calls Allah has a son or a wife, these are great sins. We are calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is perfect, is complete. He doesn't need others. We need Him. He doesn't need us. Okay? So when we say how, how is how things are, how the attributes are. You know, we say Allah is Sami'. How we don't know. He knows. He hears. Allah sees. How we don't know. Nobody can say that Allah sees by this way or that way. Nobody. إِنَّكُمْ سَتَرَوْنَ رَبَّكُمْ كَالْقَمَرِ لَيْلَةَ الْبَدْرِ لَا تُضَامُونَ فِي رُؤْيَتِهِ. In the day of judgment, we will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we will see. We can judge at that time. But now we cannot. In the day of judgment, we will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we know. But now we don't know. But we believe. We have to believe. The kayf, why Ibn Taymiyyah used the kayf, the how? He said, I used it because it was used by the Salaf, the greatest scholars of Islam, like Imam Malik, Ibn Uyayna, Al-Awza'i, Al-Khattabi, all these great scholars, they used this. When they start, these things are happening, they start mentioning this, that we don't make takyif to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't say how, because we don't know. And we know the story that the man came to Imam Malik and said, ask him, Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arsh istawa. Allah is on top of his crown. He said, how? The man, how? He asked Imam Malik, he said, he looked at him with anger. And he said to him, Al-Istiwa'u ma'loom. We know the istiwa means when you are on top of something. And asking about it is bid'ah. And the how, we don't know. Well, kayfu majhool, we don't know. And he said, even asking is a bid'ah. If you ask about these questions, you're committing a bid'ah. And he actually asked him to leave his halaqa. Because he said, call him, you are a mubtadi', you are a innovator. Get out of here. You should not ask questions that doesn't make sense. Allah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arsh istawa. Some of the interpretations of some groups, they say stawla. They said stawla means he conquered that crowd. Allah didn't do that. Allah did not mean, even the Arabic word does not, يعني, anybody who knows Arabic, the word does not, cannot accept this. You cannot get to that meaning at all. The meaning of istawa is that you're on top of something. That something is the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you cannot change the meaning. That's why Ibn Taymiyyah said, I used kaifa, how, because I know that some scholars of Islam in the early Salaf used it to stop the bid'ah. Okay. Then he said, من غير تكييف ولا تمثيل. تمثيل, you know, is equal thing. You know, they are similar to each other. And he did not use the word tashbih. You know what tashbih means? Tashbih, you know, something similar to the other. Tamthil, he used the word tamthil. Why? Because in the Quran it's used. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used that word. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is the all hearer and seer. Nothing like him. When I say my hands are مثل each other, equal to each other, they are similar, exactly similar. You can understand it. But my hand is like your hand, شبيه. Because we have five fingers, we have five nails, we have, you know, we are similar as a human beings, شبيه to each other. But when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why مثيل is more comprehensive. Nobody is like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what he's trying to say. Nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody is even close. Although, and I will mention this again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a yad, has a hand, we have a hand. Allah sees and we see. But are we equal? No. Are we the same? No. This is a very important concept to understand. So all these dimensions, you know, the things I've mentioned, that we do not call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only by the ones he described himself with, what the Prophet ﷺ described him with is a rule, without alteration or changing is a rule, without ta'til or the negation is a rule, without takyif or how is a rule, without tamthil is a rule. These are fundamentals, you don't use them. And we can see that this is also mentioned in the many of it in the Quran and the Sunnah. It's supported by the Quran and Sunnah. And we will come to this, inshallah. Now, the Shaykh says, and he said, بَلْ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِي شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ فَلَا يَنْفُونَ عَنْهُ مَا وَصَفَ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ. The Muslims or the believers believe that there is nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is the all hearer and all seer. Okay? And we do not يَنْفُونَ عَنْهُ مَا وَصَفَ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ. We do not invalidate or negate anything that he described himself with. When he described himself with something, we accept it as is. We don't change the meaning of it. Otherwise, we will commit these ta'til or tahrif or anything like that. So we have to take it as is. Now, وَلَا يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَةَ عَنْ مَوَاضِعِ. The words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to take them as is. You don't change its meaning. The ones who actually changed the meaning of the words, they started by the Jews themselves, Yahud. مُنَ الَّذِينَ هَادُوا يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَةَ عَنْ مَوَاضِعِ. The Yahud are the ones who started this. And if you read in the Torah or their Talmud, you will see how they describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by bad words. Okay? وَلَا يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ. الإلحاد, actually the word mentioned in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَاءِ. Call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the good names He has, and do not change or alter or lahd means in Arabic actually mail, means inclination. You change it slightly or something like that. But it could be complete changing and could be small changing. So al-ilhad is a very dangerous thing, because the same thing when you do ta'til, when you do takif, or when you do, when somebody does takif or alteration or tahrif, he is committing ilhad. Same thing. Okay? It's very important for us that we understand these fundamental rules. Actually, the Shaykh rahimahullah, yani we already mentioned maybe 7 or 8 rules already. We don't make ilhad, we don't have ta'til, tahrif, takyif, tamthil, we don't negate whatever he described himself with by any mean. We take it as is, we accept it, we do not change the meaning. So these are rules. And he says in the end, which is very important, he said, وَلَا يُمَثِّلُ وَلَا يُحُدُّنَ فِي أَسْمِ اللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَلَا يُمَثِّلُونَ صِفَاتُهُ بِصِفَاتِ خَلْقِهِ. Means they will not make his attributes similar to attribute of his slaves. It's not acceptable. The creator is the same as his creation. Definitely he's different. The Khaliq is different than the makhluq. He's different. So this is very important. And he said, لأنه سبحانه لا سمي له ولا كفء له ولا ند له ولا ند له. Means سبحانه وتعالى, there is no سمي, means مماثل, means similar. كفو means equal. Ned is the opponent. All these ones are not acceptable to have or calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with. There is nobody like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why these actually, all of them mentioned in the Quran. هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيَّا. Do you know something similar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is in the Quran. فَلَا تَجْعُلِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا. Don't make somebody equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كُفْوًا, كُفْوًا أَحَد. There's nobody equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, وَلَا يُقَاسُ بِخَلْقِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. You cannot make the scale. You cannot, the scale itself that you use, or the measurement in our mind, sometimes people think, use their own logic. And that's what people actually get deviated, because the people who said about Ahl al-Sunnah Mushabbiha, what did we do actually to be called this? Some of actually groups call Ahl al-Sunnah Mushabbiha, meaning that we are making Allah similar to His creation. Because when Allah says that He has a yad or a face, they said they are making Him like His slaves, like His creation. We're not doing that, we're not saying that. We're saying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran he has a face. We are believing what he said about himself. We're not saying his face is like my face or your face. We're not saying that he has a yad like my hand. No. We're saying he has a hand because he said so. Yes. This is the difference. So if somebody accuse you or give this test or confuse you with this, that you are mushabbiha because you are making, you Ahl Sunnah, you say about Allah this and this, we say Allah has described himself with these attributes, we accept it. But we don't say it, it's like mine or yours. Because he said in the Quran, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. So we cannot make the scale even. You see, the scale of Akhirah is not like the scale of this dunya. Even the days and the hours and the time, everything is different. Everything is different in the hereafter. It's a different life. Okay? So the same scale you cannot use. It's a completely different scale. The scale of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is different than our scale. We have to be sure that the meaning that you cannot compare, maybe the word compare is better actually. You don't compare a human being to the Creator. That's not right. So it has to be different. Even by logic, you said yes. Okay? Then he said, فَإِنَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ أَعْلَمُ بِنَفْسِهِ. Of course, Allah knows Himself better than we know Him, even. Allah knows Himself. Allah says in the Quran, وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. How many times do you read this in the Quran? Enough Allah to be the witness. The same thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows Himself more than we know Him. And the way He described Himself is the truth. وَأَصْدَقُ قِيلًا. He said, in the Imam said, وَأَصْدَقُ قِيلًا. That means his, what he says is truth. وَأَحْسَنُ حَدِيثًا. Better words. That's why Shaykh al-Islam, يعني, rahimahullah, when he wrote his book, he used so many verses in the Quran and so many ahadith to support his argument. And that's why it's very strong, because you cannot challenge anything he wrote. Everything he wrote, he has a proof and support from the Quran and Sunnah. He did not just fabricate things. وَأَحْسَنُ حَدِيثًا مِنْ خَلْقِهِ. He's definitely what he said. Now, even the Quran. Now, the Quran has been around us 1400 years. Allah challenged us since that time to bring something similar. That's why the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is better than the word of human being. And he challenged us to come up even with something similar, even close. So, I want to conclude here that these rules we have to understand very well, because this is the way you make the fundamental me understanding. If anybody give you, like, let me ask you a question. Actually, some groups call Ahl Sunnah Mujassima. What does it mean? Do you understand what Mujassima means? They say that Allah has jism, body. Some people call us that we call Allah has a body. We didn't call this. The deviated group accuse us with this. Why? They accuse us just like we tashbih. Because we said Allah has a face, Allah has a hand, ayn, eyes. That means we are calling just like a body. But we didn't use this term, and it's never been used actually. And actually, Shaykh al-Islam mentioned this. He said, I will refrain from using it because it's never been used. I don't know, he said. We should not even use that word. And if we are accused, same thing, the answer, the words, the attributes are listed in, are all mentioned in the Quran. If you believe in the Quran, you should believe in them. Their meanings, we should understand them, because Allah also sent this message to the Prophet and this Quran for people to understand. If we cannot comprehend it or comprehend the most of it, then it doesn't make sense. The Quran is many things. When Allah says He has a yad, He has an eye, that we have to believe in that. We cannot deny anything mentioned in the Quran. Otherwise, we're making a big mistake. That means we're saying the Quran is not complete or something wrong with it. And all of these are crimes. You know, they are not acceptable. You are committing a great sin by saying this, or even have even thoughts about it. You believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran is His words, and these are His attributes, you have to believe in them. The how, the equal, the shbih, all this are not acceptable. Nobody's like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot make measurements between His slaves and the Khaliq subhanahu. They are completely different. But we affirm what He affirms for Himself. We negate what He negated for Himself. Simple. Okay? I think this is maybe conclude about this subject. If you have any question, inshallah, we'll answer. Jazakumullah khair.